I'm Taking This Medication, Can I Dive? By Brian Harper, performed by Dr. Franz Cronier. One of the most frequently asked questions to DAN medics is whether it's safe to dive while on a particular medication. The answer to this issue is rarely straightforward. Many divers assume DAN has a repository of data on how various medications are affected by the diving environment. Unfortunately, such data do not exist. Ethical concerns preclude formal research trials that would evaluate the influence of drugs on human dives in underwater environments. Anecdotal reports of diving accidents are of limited value in determining whether it's safe to dive while taking a particular drug or not, and there are generally too many physical and physiological variables involved to allow isolation to a single variable of the medication. That's not to say, however, that it's impossible to provide sound advice when these questions are asked. By considering the medical condition being treated, the physical demands on humans in the diving environment, and known facts about the drugs from clinical trials conducted on land, recommendations can be made. Generally speaking, divers call DAN about medications and diving because they are concerned about the chances of developing new side effects at depth. It's certainly possible that certain drugs may potentiate or otherwise be potentiated by diving. For instance, the narcotic effect of nitrogen may be enhanced. A diver should consider this possibility if planning to dive deeper than 24 meters while taking a drug that warns against, for instance, operating heavy machinery, as would be the case with alcohol. Aside from this theoretical concern, most drugs are not suspected to incur specific biological hazards simply because of immersion, pressure, or breathing gas mixture. It is understandable for divers to be apprehensive about new side effects during a dive, but the more important issue, to medical professionals at least, is usually the underlying medical condition, and that makes it safe or less safe. The injury or illness being treated is more likely than the medication to exclude someone from diving. Diminished physical fitness is not uncommon amongst people who are being treated for some medical condition. And although diving itself is a relaxing activity for most recreational divers, it does also involve lifting and wearing heavy equipment, as well as entering and exiting the water, which can be strenuous. Divers should always have sufficient physical reserve to fight a current, perform a fairly long swim on the surface, or help a buddy in the case of an emergency. They should not be at an increased risk of barotrauma as a result of congestion, and they should not have symptoms like numbness, tingling, or pain that could be confused with decompression sickness after a dive. In addition to the implications of the underlying condition, it is important to consider whether a diver has experienced any side effects from medication, how long he or she has been taking it, and what other drugs or medicines the diver may be taking. Before diving, while taking a particular medicine, the person should have experience with it on land. For most prescriptions, at least a month is recommended to ensure that the dosage is correct and to reveal any side effects that the diver is likely to experience. At least one doctor should be aware of all the medications an individual is taking to minimize the risk of drug interactions. A diver who experiences any side effects that could cause distraction or decrease awareness underwater should not dive while taking it. In addition to these general considerations, there are some specific questions and points for discussion as they relate to particular types of medication. The following issues and concerns should be addressed during the physician's evaluation, as well as in the diver's assessment. In the case of orthopedic pain medications or muscle relaxants, could the pain or impaired mobility cause distraction or physical limitation during the dive? Might heavy dive gear exacerbate an injury? Could side effects of the prescription strength pain relievers diminish a diver's alertness or awareness? Might soreness, numbness, or tingling be confused with decompression sickness after a dive? Neurological drugs. Are the diver's physical capabilities diminished? Has the diver ever experienced a seizure? Could any drugs that the diver is taking cause side effects that could be confused with decompression sickness? Psychiatric medications. Might symptoms or the drug side effects impair judgment, behavior, awareness, or the ability to handle stress? Is the patient's condition managed successfully or in remission? Gastrointestinal drugs. Is the patient at risk for gas trapping that could cause barotrauma on ascent? Is the diver dehydrated due to vomiting or diarrheal illness? Cardiovascular drugs. Does the diver have a cardiovascular health and exercise issue that reduces their capacity to dive safely? Is it necessary to conduct a stress EKG to confirm good cardiac fitness? Respiratory medications, including inhaled cortisone. Is there reason to suspect air trapping or an impaired ability to breathe while diving? Does the individual have asthma? If so, they should undergo exercise challenge testing, including pulmonary function testing before and after exercise in a clinical setting. Decongestants, antihistamines, and intranasal steroids. Is the diver congested and therefore at increased risk of sinus or middle ear barotrauma? Was the congestion recent? What happens if the medication wears off at depth? Will it cause problems such as reverse blocks? If they're antihistamines, are they of a sedating kind that may affect the diver? Hormones, insulin, and medications used to treat diabetes. Are the patient's hormone levels stable and close to normal? Is the diabetic diver at risk of hypoglycemia with exercise? If the diver has diabetes, do they have good health and fitness? And are they experienced in managing blood glucose levels while exercising? Antibiotics. Does the patient have an illness or infection that might be complicated by diving? A laceration may become infected. A respiratory infection may cause air trapping, etc. And chemotherapy drugs. Is the person physically fit to dive? Is it a type of cancer that warrants particular consideration, like lung cancer? Are there medical ports, intravenous access points, that may be a problem unless they are padded well? All these points should be considered both in the context of the symptoms, of the medical condition, and the side effects of the drug used to treat it. The focus should be on whether any of these factors might lead to impairment of the diver's physical capabilities, awareness, reaction time, or judgment. Now, the list we gave is by no means exhaustive, but it highlights some of the concerns that may accompany certain medical conditions and medication. Any medical condition or medication should prompt a diver to seek a physician's approval before diving. And as always, Dan is available to discuss the relevant concerns of injuries, illnesses, and medications used to treat them. If you have questions, call the Dan Medical Information Line or email us at dan@dan.com.